when I was 23, I got married. I married the person who was 2 years younger to me. So, you know, that also made me feel that as you grow up, you know, women normally age faster than men. So I thought that I should always continue exercising, and my husband also always wanted me to be thin. So I just kept going. And unfortunately, after a year of my wedding, I got very severe arthritis. And you know what arthritis is. It's all your joints start aching, and it all started. And then I was 24 years of age, I got pregnant. When I was pregnant, arthritis totally went away. There was not a single joint that used to pain at that time. But then, at the age of 26, like after 9.5 months, I delivered my son. And that time, after 1.5 months of the delivery, I again started getting pains. You know, it started with my shoulder, then it went to the knee. So, you know, I used to go to the doctor, Hardwick, so we used to go to those doctors, and then he used to put a bandage over here, then next day it would be somewhere else. So 3-4 days, it's it used to shift from here to here, here to there. And then ultimately I thought I should go to a better doctor. So I went to a joint specialist, and then he said that it might be something like an arthritis. But at that time we never thought, this was before 19 years. So we never thought that arthritis would happen to us in such an early age. But he said that it's something like arthritis, so we were worried. So we went to so many, I was not even able to lift my son. I was not even able to feed him. Like I had to fold my hands, and my mom would come and put him in my lap, and I had to. It was very, very bad. I mean, I could not even get up and go to the bathroom. My husband had to carry me. We had a huge dressing room from where I was supposed to go to the bathroom. But it was very difficult. I could not even get up from the bed. I have actually gone through 2 surgeries in both the knees. So, you know, I can say that, I mean, it was the worst thing a person would go through. And at that time, another thing happened that, you know, we were very money people. We had everything that we wanted, and same time, you know, something because of the recession, because of the earthquake, and lot of things. We had a huge bungalow, but we had to sell off the bungalow at that time. And because of the business problems, my husband went into depression, severe depression. We had to go take him to the psychiatrist also. I mean, they would be surprised knowing that, but it was terrible. We had to go to the doctors for him. I mean, everything was going wrong at that time. And selling of the bungalow, before we sold the bungalow, I started my exercise classes over there, because the doctor recommended that you should exercise. If you don't exercise, you'll never be able to come out of your arthritis. So, you know, I actually started my exercise classes at my residence, wherein we had a basement. So we started, 2 or 3 people started in a bedroom, but then gradually, because more people started pouring in, we shifted to the basement. And then maybe I think 2 or 3 years we did it over there, and then this was the time when we had to sell off the bungalow. And then at that time we were not sure what to do, because I mean we were literally, I can say, we had gone bankrupt. It was bad. My arthritis on one side, no money. And but you know, at the same time we somebody told us, like, you know, we had started going with this Amway business, and in that there's a grid system which gave us very good information, or what you say, knowledge about positive thinking and lot of things that you should, that keeps you going. So we started reading a lot of positive thinking books, and ultimately, you know, we thought that one day I went to the doctor with my husband, and then after we came back from the doctor's place, he said, okay, why do you need to go to the doctor? I mean, your life is in your hands. You know what to do. Your health is in your hands. Your life is in your hands. So we thought that it's better that we think about something, what we want to do. And somehow we started taking things positively at that time. And then we shifted to a studio. I mean, we made a new studio. We shifted to a place which was not at all equivalent to our old bungalow. because the bungalow in which we were staying had been actually published in one or two big magazines like Inside Outside and many other. So it was the bungalow was published along with the Chimanbhai Patel's bungalow. It was a great one. But after that we shifted to another place which was not very good. But then we stayed there for 2 years. I started my classes also over there for 2 years. But then we badly wanted to shift because it was not a good place and not a place of our level. That is what we always thought. But it was in a hurry, so we had to do that. After that, we again shifted my classes somewhere else. We stayed at the same place for about 4-5 months. Again, we shifted our residence. So, 4 to 5 times we shifted our residences also. And then again, we shifted the studio, and it was a big hassle. Because if you stop in between, then people would stop coming to you. You have so many clients coming to you, and if all of a sudden you stop, then they would not want to stop exercising. But then we always thought that you have to stick on to it. That time my son was also very small, gradually. But I had very good support from my parents, my in-laws, and my husband. My husband supports me a lot till right now also. He's always, always there to help me. And he pushes me so much that I can say that it's mainly because of him that I'm at this place. I've achieved whatever I had. And the best way to stick on to people is you have to be very polite to them. You have to listen to them. It's not that, if your customers are always right, you always have to think that your customers are always right. So whenever they come and talk to you, you should sit down and listen to them very, very carefully, and you have to look in their eyes. It's not that, if they have something to tell you, then only they come to you. Otherwise, they'll not. Today I can say that just because we are being very, very helpful and very kind to the people that who come to us, they've stuck on to you. I've got so many clients who've been coming to me since last 12-13 years, since the day I started my studio. And they are still with me, and they just don't want to go to somebody else. And about my friends, I can say that I still have it, but I always feel that it's all in your mind. It's all in your mind. Sometimes it happens that in the night, maybe 3 or 4 o'clock, I feel that I'll not even be able to get up because arthritis never goes. Of course, I'm taking the medication, I'm taking a lot of supplements and all. But sometimes I feel that how will I take the batch in the morning? And my husband tells me that you call up another instructor and she'll do it for you. But then I always feel that no, I'll take it, I'll do it, I'll manage it somehow. And I go to the batch, I tell my clients that I am not well today, so I may not be able to take the full batch, but they always support me because they know. But once I enter the class, those vibrations, those waves, I forget everything. And after that 1 hour, when I come out of the class, I feel that it was painy, but now it's not. So it's all in your mind, it's all in your mind. Whatever you want, you will get it. But if you feel that, if you don't try, just do it. Just do it. That is what we've done. And that is why we are so successful. Thank you. I'm not able to afford your fees or whatever, then I just tell them, come and do it. I don't want fees from you. Because we want people to be healthy. We want people to come and exercise, because if you are healthy, then you'll be able to enjoy everything in your life. So right now is a period when I can say that, and I have a dream wherein I want to have 1 or 2 batches in which all kinds of people can come and exercise and will not charge them at all. Because there are many people who really want to exercise, but they cannot afford. So that time we had to, of course, arrange for money. We did not have enough money to start a new studio. It's not much by then also. But the times have changed, and right now, it was like riches to rags, and now it's back to riches. We have everything we want right now, everything in the world, and of course, we are succeeding more and more. We have not advertised at all. Only when we were shifting, we always had a small budget of giving in the newspaper that we are shifting to this place. so that all the people who have left and who have not been coming since a few months or so, they can come, or maybe other people will also know. But we have never advertised, but it's just word of mouth, and it's just, as I told you, that, you know, people always feel that there's something in us, something in me or my instructors, which pull them. You know, we are always very, very, very friendly with them, and I can say that, as I told you about the fees also, and whatever questions they have, I always tell them that you can call me at any hour, whatever time. If you go out for shopping, then, and if you want to buy something, I always tell them to check the nutrition facts and buy the things. So, you know, I always tell them that if you've gone for shopping, then also you can call me. So, you know, it's just a one-on-one relationship that I have with my clients, with all my clients. And I always sit with them for diet counseling, and we don't charge anything for that also. Because if they come to exercise, then of course, if they want to get good results, then you have to be very helpful to them. Otherwise, I mean, you can just take the money, they can exercise for a few days or few months and go away. But if they're coming, we want them to get good results. So it's just one-on-one or a very, very personal relationship that you should develop with your clients. And they should feel as if they are a family, as if they are a part of the system. Like, you know, my studio is Neha's Fitness Studio. But we have a team also, and we have lots of get-togethers. We just had a party wherein each and every client was invited. And, you know, we just keep doing such things. On Valentine's Day also, we had great fun. We had decorated the studio. On the next day, it was my husband's birthday. That day also, we did something. And each and every person gets involved in that. Each and every instructor that we have. We have many instructors. We've got about 8 batches going on right now in throughout the day. And we've got salsa classes also going on. But you know, each and every person who comes is involved. Nobody feels, even my instructors feels that it's their own place. They don't feel that they are working over there. Everybody feels that it's their own place. And you know, one more thing, a lot of people come and tell us that it's this 1 hour only in the whole day that we feel that we are giving it to ourselves. You know, otherwise the lady is always after her children or after the husband or after the in-laws or after the housework. But this is just 1 hour.